Hey everyone, pulling a random data point out of thin air, I'd say about 90% of web APIs are REST APIs. Now, don't quote me on the percent, like I said, I made it up. The point is, there's a lot of data behind REST APIs, and we need to know how to connect our iOS apps to get to that data. In this tutorial, we're going to write Swift code to perform a GET and POST request. Now, if you're not familiar with REST, here's a quick 30-second CliffsNote version.
REST is an architectural style for creating a web service that almost always works over HTTP. It works pretty much the same way as getting web pages, but you also have standard methods to create, update, and delete. If your computer can do web, it can do REST. That's why everyone's using it. Since we're doing GET and POST, that means we're focusing on read and create. To make our REST calls, we're going to use a few online testing servers. We'll use httpbin.org and requestb.in, or requestbin. Building a REST server is out of the scope for this tutorial. We'll cover that in other lessons with other languages. Let's take a look at some code. The complete code for this is all on GitHub. In order to make a GET REST call using Swift, we first need a URL for our GET call. The URL we'll use is https://httpbin.org with the path IP. This URL represents the resource we're trying to get. In our case, we're asking the REST service for our IP address. Behind the scenes, the REST service will just read it out of our request and return it as JSON. The next thing we need is an instance of nsurlSession. This is the object we're using to make the REST request. It has a method called dataTaskWithURL. It takes the URL we created and the completion handler. The method returns a task which we call resumeOn. The completion handler contains our code that is run when we get a result. We get back the data, a response, and hopefully nothing in the error. In our handler, we'll just unpack the data into JSON, which we'll convert into a dictionary, and we'll use that to populate into a label. Since this code is in a completion handler, which is a different thread, we perform a selector to update the label. Okay, that's all done. We should test the response code in our completion handler to make sure we get a response. If we get an HTTP status code of 200, that means we should have data in the response body. Otherwise, something happened and we need to account for it. I'm only testing for 200. But we could write special code for 404s or my favorite, 418. Okay, one last thing I wanted to note was the URL we used for the GET was HTTPS. That wasn't an accident. In iOS 9, all of our REST requests should be over HTTPS. If they're not, iOS will throw an app transport security error since our request is in clear text. To get around that, we can create a temporary exception in our info plist. Apple uses the word temporary in the exception message, so I'm taking that to mean that we can do it for now, but who knows for how long. Here's how we create an exception. Right-click on the info plist for our application and open it as source code. Instead of getting the plist editor, we'll get the plist file as XML. We need to add a key and a dictionary for that key. Ultimately, the exception we're adding contains the domain name for the exception and subkeys and dictionaries for specific flags like allowing insecure HTTP loads, minimum TLS, and if we should include subdomains. Don't include the HTTP part for the domain name. In our case, it's just requestb.in. You want to add this code somewhere under the main dict element for the plist. This will allow you to make REST calls to HTTP servers that are not encrypted. So let's post some data. To post data, we set things up the same way. We need an endpoint URL, an NSURL session, and an array of key value pairs to post as JSON. I'm just using a simple array with the key hello and the value is hello post world. Once we have those, we need to build a request object using the NSMutable URL request class. We set the method as the string post. We also need to create a header variable for a request that tells the other server that what we're sending in the body of our message. In this example, we're using JSON. To make that request, we'll use a different call on the session object. We'll use data task with request. Instead of passing the URL, we'll pass a request object. The request object has the URL when we created it. We call it the same way as before with a completion handler, to perform any actions after we post the request. Now this server just responds with the word OK and a status code of 200. To see what the server received, we can go to the URL for requestb.in. There we'll see our request and any other requests we've recently made. The data is ephemeral, so don't expect it to be there for more than a few minutes.
All right, we've seen how to perform gets and posts. We've also looked at how we add exceptions if our REST server is blocked using insecure resource loads. The complete source code is available on GitHub, and the link is in the description. So thanks for watching. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. I try to have new videos every week, so make sure you subscribe because you don't want to miss a video. On a side note, before I go, the DGU.com website is down for upgrades over the next week. Videos, they'll still be posted here. And with that, I'll see you in the next tutorial.